That's what they've done. There is a big risk, of course, too, Colin, that the engine will be very, very warm. Extremely warm, of course. They'll only get one amber and then the green, and it's away they go. And it looks like Jimmy Walton has shut the car down. The car is switched off. The Jimmy Walton car is switched off, I think. It's a solo run by Al Hoffman, I believe. Is he or isn't he? Qualifying this afternoon, they put a time down, but unfortunately burned a lot of pistons. Here we go, Peter Russo, lane one. Sounding exceptionally sweet. Likewise, Graham Cowan really keeps that power down, gives it a couple of on and offs the flow to make sure he doesn't overrev that motor. The Russo car looking very, very radical with that new wing setup.
Yeah, both cars absolutely sounding as sweet as a kitten out there, Colin. Beautiful burnouts by both vehicles. Peter Russo's car sounding easily as strong as any of them. Graham Cowan and Steve Brown's Warlord car out there, an exceptional motor car. Been around for some couple of years now in Australia, and what a pretty looking effort this one is.
Yes, in fact, the original driver of that car when it came out here, or one of the original people that had a driver, Rocky Epperly down there, I noticed on the start line also with them.
Oh, that's good to see too. Peter Russo, lane one. Graham Cowan, lane two. The current Australian funny car champion over there in lane two.
Both these guys flying the flag for Australia. Let's see if they can lay down an ET quicker than a 6.18. That's what we're looking for. We're looking for a time quicker than a 6.18. Graham Cowan looks to be staged, Colin.
Yes, I believe he is completely staged. No, he's out of stage. He's just back away from staging. He's started not to move up until such time as Russo's into pre-stage. Both lights on now, and Cowan's lights don't appear to be lit up from here.
Unbelievable destruction of an engine there in the Warlord car in lane two. An unbelievable explosion underneath the body. Oh boy, Graham Cowan's ears will be ringing for a few hours after that one. Peter Russo. Peter Russo stops the cross with a 681 at 219 miles an hour, but what an awesome explosion out of a Warlord car. Oh, brother, is that expensive.
Yes, bits and pieces on the track over there. Looks like the supercharger's come clean off the top of the motor. That's the inlet manifold laying on the ground over there right now. Jim Mose will just make sure that Graham Cowan is quite okay.
Let's wait on for a report from Graham Cowan down there. That's a horrible thing to happen to
car,
believe you me.
Okay, Graham Cowan looks quite okay. He's out of the car right now. He's just walking around inside the car. That would have been one heck of a bang inside that car, believe you me. Something let go there as the car just